Hello, good morning. Students, today we are going to take a quick revision on HTML. As we have completed this lesson already, so we are going to take a small and quick revision. So let's get started. First, what is an HTML? So HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. And what does HTML do? So it designs the web pages, and whatever program we write it in the brackets, and that brackets are called as tags. So when you write the tags, you need to close a tag, right? You need to open a tag and you need to close a tag. Then what we have to do is, when you are closing a tag, we have to give a slash. For example, HTML and slash HTML. Same way, file and slash file, like that. HTML programs are written in Notepad, and when you are saving your programs, that time you have to give .html as an extension. That is, when you will write your file name, that time .html should be in the last. You can't write .htm, you can't write .ht, or you can't write all capital, one small, one big, like that. So everything should be perfect while writing the HTML extension. And you can add your pictures, you can add tables, links, forms, and etc. to make a web page attractive. Now let's learn today parts of the table, that is how to insert table in HTML. So there are three parts of table. One is row, another one is column, and another one is cell. So a row is horizontal line which is grouped into head, foot and body. So header, footer and your body. And column is nothing but a vertical line which contains a particular value. So students, this is your row. So this is a horizontal line. So row, column, cell, what I have written, that will be your row. And this three, that is vertical lines, will be your columns. And what is a cell? So cell is nothing but a rectangular box which may span multiple rows and multiple columns, however you want. So these are the parts of a table. But students, to write in an HTML or to draw a table in HTML, you need tags. So what are the tags for it? Let's learn it. So first one is table tag. If you want a table, then table tag is must. Then comes tr tag, td tag, th tag and caption tag. So all these tags are used in table. And students, everyone has the ending tags, that is slash table, slash tr, slash td, slash th and slash caption. What does this all do? So table tag is used to insert a table. TR is nothing but table row, and it is used to insert a new row into your table. Same goes with TD. TD stands for table data, and it inserts a new data and a new column. Then there is table heading. Table heading is nothing but used to insert your row as a header. So you must have seen that in your table there is a row which is your header, that is which is the main part and which is most of all written in bold. So there you have to use th, that is table heading. And then goes caption. So students, caption tag, if you want to give a name to your table, then or a title to your table, then you can take the help of caption tag and it will be on the top of the table. So this all tags are there in HTML. Now this table tag has some attributes. Now what are the attributes? Attributes are nothing but used to make your table look more good and more attractive. So attributes are nothing but there in your table or in your tags only. They are nothing but a part which will let you do something more attractive. So first one is border. Border is used to give a border to your table tag or to your table. If you want any border, the height, width and anything of it, so you can choose the border attribute. Then comes border color, so it gives color to your border. Then comes BG color. Students, BG stands for background. You can see it here, B and G. So BG stands for background, and if you want a solid background color of your table or a particular row or a particular column or a particular cell, then you can take BG color. And if you want a photo or an image into your background, then you can take the background attribute into your table, row or column or cell. Then comes students, cell spacing. Now what is cell spacing? And there is one more, that is cell padding. So what is cell spacing? So cell spacing gives the amount of space between the cells, space between the cells. And what is cell padding? So cell padding is it gives the space between cell border and the content of the cell. So cell border and content of cell is nothing but cell padding, and the space between the cell is cell spacing. Now students, alignment or align attribute is used to give the alignment to your table. That is, if you want your table in the right of your web page, if you want it on the left of the web page, or if you want it in the center of the web page, so you can take align attribute for it. Then students, there is height, and also there is one more, that is width. So you can specify the height and width or the dimensions as a number or in terms of percentage available on the screen. So this nothing but gives the height or specifies the height and width of the table. Then students, let's come to the TD attribute tag. So here also same, only four attributes are there. You can add more attributes to it too, but right now we are going to learn only this four. So TD has four attributes: align, that is alignment, right, left, center, or justify. So students, this TD is nothing but table data, right? So it can either be given to your particular cell or to your particular column. So students, alignment will only, if you are giving it in TD, then it will only be given to your cell or your column. So alignment of the data, whichever you have written in it, and then the width of your data, that is how much size you want of the cell, you want it in pixels or you want it in percentage value, you can take it from here. And then BG color, as I said, solid color background will come. So you can change the color, background color of each cell in a table also. You can mix all the colors, you can give numerous colors, different colors for each background color. Then comes background. As I said, it is used to apply a picture as a background of each cell in a table. Now students, as I said in our earlier slide, that the table row is divided into three types, that is table head, table body and table foot, that is header, footer and body. So let's learn about that. So here it is written table can be divided into table, table head, table body and table foot. So there are three tags for it. TH, that is T head. Now students, TH is different and T head is different. See students, T head, if you give T head before any of the tag or before caption or after caption or before the body, then it will consider that whole part as your header only. And T body is, if you, it will create the groups of rows in a table body, and T foot is nothing but it will create that whole group of rows into a footer row. And same goes here, T head will convert whole row into table head. So head stands for header, body and foot stands for footer. Now students, call span and row span. So call span can merge or span two or more columns into one column, and row span will span or merge two or more rows into one column. So you can see here, call is for columns and row is for rows. So span is nothing but mixing or merging two columns or two cells or two rows. So you can take call span or call row if you want to merge any of your row or column. And students, it takes number as a value, so you can't add it by percentage. Now let's learn hyperlinks. What are hyperlinks? So students, whenever you have a text or image, or whenever you visit a web page, then you might have seen that there is a link. Every time there are links, when you click on that links, then it takes you to some another web page or some another file. So that are nothing but hyperlinks. So that hyperlinks can either be your text, that can either be an image or whatever, anything part. Whenever you click on it, it will take you to the another page or file, or either on that website or anywhere else on the internet. So these are hyperlinks. And students, whenever you move your cursor to or over a link in a web page, then that arrow, which the pointer, will turn into a little hand. That is, if you want to know that if this is a hyperlink or not, then you can just take the take the cursor to your hyperlink, and that will directly change into your hand. So a little hand shows that it is a hyperlink. Now for hyperlink, A tag is used, and that A tag is standing for anchor tag. There are two types of hyperlink. One is internal hyperlink and another one is external hyperlink. Students, internal hyperlink is used to link a part of the same document, and external hyperlink is used to link one document with another document, that is externally. Now there are three tags of attributes of A tag. So href, first one is href, that is nothing, stands for hypertext reference, href. So students, it is nothing but it is used to give the web address of link resource, which could be a document, it could be your multimedia file or any part of the same document. So href is used to give the address, web address. Then there comes tag target, which is used with frames, and it defines nothing but where to open the document and the URL and specified href. But students, nowadays it is not in use, but you might know it. So next is name. So students, name is nothing but name attribute, and that attribute is used to define a name to your anchor, that is any name, like a name given to your anchor. then students comes forms. So you might have seen nowadays we are having our test in Google Forms, right? So there are worksheets, there are forms. In Google Forms, what you see, there are most of all multiple choice questions, right? So whenever you click on it, you might have buttons, some multiple choice question have most of all check boxes, or there are radio buttons. So students, this that are nothing but forms. So in HTML also you can have forms. So HTML forms are used to take the data as input and from the users and pass them to the web server, so for further processing. And it can contain input elements like text field, text area, checkbox and radio button, and action buttons like submit, reset, clear, etc. And students, to create a form we need the help of form tag. So you can add HTML tags in it, you can add table in it, you can add image in it, but only between form tag and slash form tag. Otherwise it will the table or your image or other tags will open somewhere else. So you need to be careful to open it between form and slash form tags. So let's learn about form controls. That is, what are the elements or input elements for it. So first one is text box. Students, text box is nothing but a area where we have to write, but it will only take single input data. Then there comes buttons. Now students, button, they are clickable buttons, and whenever you click on it, it will either submit it, it will either reset it, or it will either clear it. Then comes checkbox. Now if you want to select multiple options, then you can select, or you have to take checkbox as your input. Then radio button can only select one option. That is, if you want a single option to be selected, then you need to choose radio button as your input control. Then student comes list box. So list box is also used to take a select multiple as well as single. If you want a single, then you can choose single. Then if you want multiple choices, then you can, or options, then you can choose that also in a list box. And it will have a small scroll bar like this. Then comes students drop down list. So drop down list is also known as combo box, and whenever you click on such arrow, then the list is going to open and it will show you more options which are there in it. So it is also used to select a single option at a time. Then comes students text area. Now what is a text area? So text area will help you to write text in more than one line. That is, if you want your if you want to write the feedback, if you want to write a long answer or a long essay or anything more than a one line, then you need to take text area as your input. And at last here is file upload. So when you click on this choose file, then you can it will directly take you to your browser, or it will directly take you to your files wherever you want to upload anything. So this was it, and I hope that you have understood about everything. So I am ending my lesson over here. And students, what you have to do is you have to just see all the programs which are there in your textbook. Just see it one by one, and if you have computer in your homes, then just practice it one by one all. And also there are some other tags, that is input tag, which is also used for form tag. So I want you to do that in your home as your homework. And if you have any doubt, I'm always there for you. Okay? Bye.